Good morning, coffee drinkers. Hello from Edinburgh, Scotland. Today's vlog is not running around, it is not fancy, it is not touristy, it does not have the super fancy Chelsea Stevens element that yesterday's one had, but what it does have is one of my, I guess, it's not really a pet peeve, but it's a really tough subject in terms of being on the road and wanting to practice or being able to maintain your chops, and that is, how do you practice without an amp? I'm here in our hotel, I mean, it's more of an apartment actually, but it's, you know, on the road accommodation. I'm not home, I do not have my cabinets, my amp, I don't have any of that stuff. I do have my pedals, I do have my amp. I could, if I wanted to, set all that up and plug the headphones in and practice. But when you don't have all that stuff, perhaps you don't have backline with you, perhaps backline is on the tour bus or something, and you are just in the hotel with your bass and you still want to practice, really, really important to be able to feel comfortable with that. It took me a really long time to be comfortable with that. It's something that's still not really that inspiring. I'm not like as inspired to practice without the amp as I am with it. I'm definitely not as inspired to practice on the road as I am at home most of the time. But there's definitely that element of wanting to do maintenance and wanting to be ready for a gig, you know. And this week I didn't do it actually. I was actually gonna say, by the way, I had a gig and I did that. I didn't do it. I had a gig on Monday. I left the bass in the case for 4 days. And then I took it out on soundcheck on Friday and played the gig. And I did warm up for about 10 minutes on the soundcheck and maybe 5 minutes right before the show started. But other than that, really didn't practice at all this week. But that's quite unusual for me. And you know, we're on vacation. This is not a tour by any means. So let's really focus in on talking about being on the road. Let's say you're playing, conservatively speaking, 3 or 4 shows a week. Maybe if you have a heavy schedule, it's 5 or 6 shows, but you still want to do a little bit of work during the day if you're over the jet lag and you're feeling motivated. As soon as I started to realize that, okay, it's really just exactly like practicing at home, only really quiet, that kind of opened up a bunch of doors. And I always start simple. I'm not enhancing the audio by any means in the edit here or in the mix. I'm just playing acoustically so you can hear what it sounds like in relation to the volume of my voice. It's not that quiet. I can still hear every note. And I can still hear articulation and vibrato and all of those things. Chords kind of work. These strings are a little old. I can even tell that the strings are kind of old. I can tell that by feel and I can tell that by sound as well. Because I've played 2 shows on them already and they're pretty much done. Actually, that brings up a great point that practicing on new strings on the road, they're kind of a little bit brighter. If you have if you have that luxury to change your strings often, that can be kind of a motivating factor. I've found that when I've been on the road, that it's motivating. Change your strings, they sound a little brighter, they feel a little more, I don't know, a little tighter, a little tougher in the hands. There's more to play against, that can be a thing. Also, running through my same set of warm-up exercises. You know, you've seen me do this one before with the fingers. I do kind of 10 reps on each one, so 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I might do 3 or 4 sets of 10 on each digit. That's always a good warm up for the fingers. I do this thing, maybe piano players do this, I'm not sure. Let me move the camera and give you a better view of this. So that's everything symmetrical. So we're doing exactly the same thing with both hands. 2 inside, 2 outside, then do opposite. So 2 inside here, 2 outside there, and go back and forth. I don't know whether this is a piano player thing or what it is, general hand exercise, but I use it, it's quite useful. Then do the first finger and ring finger, and then middle finger and pinky. Again, do it the same on both hands, and then do, woo, I haven't practiced one in a while, and then do opposite. So just having those warm-ups really exercises the fingers, kind of, even if I can't touch the bass, I'll do those. Like, I can do that and leave the bass in the flight case, and that's at least a little bit of exercise for the fingers and kind of gets the blood flowing and makes them feel less stagnant. We've been noticing, we've been walking a lot this week and in altitude a little bit, like, you, fingers get a little bit swollen, you kind of get out of your comfort zone. It's good to get back in the comfort zone and do some things that you're used to and really do some maintenance with the fingers, definitely making sure they're not getting stiff. Another thing about hot and cold and about changing weather conditions, I'm always thinking about that. Sometimes it's really easy and you're in a hot climate and you just don't even think about it. Hey, we're in Scotland right now. It is by no means warm, and it's June. You know, we had amazing weather in further south in England, but we're in Scotland. It's not warm at all, and that's definitely a consideration. And last night, as you saw if you saw yesterday's vlog, the green room was through the room where they keep the beer kegs in the basement of the club. So it was freezing in there. So despite having sat in the car with the heater on, you know, trying to get warm before the gig, I actually went and sat in the green room stupidly for 10 minutes before the show and got really cold again. So that took me 10 minutes to get really into the gig and to get warmed up. And, you know, I started with my jacket on, you know, so it took me a while to get down to the t-shirt and to get warmed up again. So that's exactly the same things I'm thinking about when I'm practicing without the amp. And I'm going through exactly the same thing. Sometimes I'll drop my ear down to the bass and then you can really hear the notes resonate. It's not the greatest position to be in for a long time, but you can really hear the notes resonate through the instrument. In fact, that was really loud. Holy cow. It was like putting my ear on the sounding board of a piano or something and having someone play a really big chord. I think you do get a little more connected to the instrument when you practice without the amp. So there can be some benefit to it. It's just for me not that realistic in terms of the process and in terms of the sound output and in terms of the velocity with which I'm plucking with the right hand. So I try to do it as little as possible, but sometimes it's just essential. Sometimes you're in the middle of nowhere, you're in a hotel, you have to practice, and it is what it is. So I'm running through stuff from all the good stuff, kind of my standard practice routine, you know, picking any one of like 30 or more exercises. If you don't know what all the good stuff is, I'm sure all of you do by now, but if you don't, there's a link for it right below in the description of this video. It's just kind of my exercise book of all these things that I use while I'm on the road. And some of them are really specific to a certain problem. They provide a solution to a certain technical problem or technical hitch. So really good to be aware of what it is in your playing that needs a little work, what's lacking, and what you need to use to work on it. And of course, the stuff in all the good stuff is really personal to me. It has definitely worked for other people, and it may well work for you. It may well not. You may have to develop your own exercises to, you know, find the solution to issues you're having in your playing. But just, you don't have to be that complex. It doesn't have to be that dense. And I find, just as I've talked about before, if you only have 10 or 15 minutes, you can really get a lot of work done. It doesn't have to be this hour-long tirade of 1,000 different things. I can pick one exercise, maybe sit here with the metronome even, slightly quieter, obviously, than I normally would, and just work through it sequentially up and down the instrument, really covering as much range as I can. Not only range in terms of harmonic range, but also in terms of tempo range as well. I love to start way down. Some nice low tempo like that. And really work sequentially through an exercise, so cycle of fifths. And maybe I'll play each exercise twice in each position. And I won't always use the metronome. Right now I'm not using the metronome, I'm staying pretty much on the tempo. It just depends how much discipline I need to give myself and how new a particular exercise might be to me. And even right now, I'm sitting here practicing. You know, I hadn't really planned to practice. I knew I wanted to talk about this because it's something that's really important. It's something that is happening right now. I'm not home. I don't have an amp. And this is the typical situation that I find myself in when I have to practice. And for not wanting to practice, for it being almost 10 o'clock at night, having an early flight tomorrow, having just come back from dinner, being pretty mellow and relaxed, it actually feels good to be with the instrument, to sit with the instrument, and really gauge where I'm at, you know, where my playing's at, where my technique is at, where my feel is at, where the sound is at. You can get all of those things out of practicing without the amp, I think, anyway. And it's for you to judge and for you to feel out and see where you sit in that kind of arena and that process. And everyone is so different. I'd be really interested to hear your feedback. Like, do you practice without an amp? Is that something you do even when you have the option to practice with an amp? Do you spend some time at home practicing without it? How much time do you practice on the road? Are you motivated to practice on the road? Is that something you're like, okay, I've got to practice every day? Is that something you're really into? Or perhaps you're like me and I'm not motivated to practice every day on the road, especially when I'm playing a lot of shows. The last leg of the last world tour was a lot of 18 or 19 shows in 3 weeks. That was, you know, we're talking about 5 or 6 shows every week. And that was kind of intense, like, and a lot of travel in between. So sometimes there just wasn't the time. But even when there was the time and maybe I had a day off, I really found it was beneficial to take some time away from the instrument. So give me your feedback. Leave me some comments below about how you manage that. You know, it'd be very interesting, very inspiring to see that cross-section of everyone, where you're at, how that compares to me. You're probably going to give me 1,000 ideas of how I can improve my process through your experience. So leave comments below. Don't be shy to do that. Maybe you have, you know, a good internet connection at the hotel where you're staying and you can watch Netflix. Some Netflix and chill actually becomes Netflix and shed. You know, you can actually get some damage done and binge House of Cards. I'd be lying if I said I hadn't done that before on the road, or just binging a TV show and practicing. That's, for me, a great way to get it done, especially if it's just technical maintenance. Typically not the most inspiring thing that we do in our practice routine, even though I'm hugely motivated to do it most of the time. It's typically not the most inspiring thing we do. But give me your feedback. Again, I'm not going to go on too long about this. That's my take on it. Let me know what your take is on it by leaving me some comments below. Today's vlog is done. We're off to Switzerland, holy cow, in just a few hours. So I will see you from sunny Geneva tomorrow.